Till now, we have obtained the phasor diagrams of series RL, series RC, and series RLC circuits. And now we are going to have the phasor diagram, current triangle, admittance triangle, and power triangle for parallel RL circuit. And here I have taken the parallel RL circuit. Resistor and inductor are connected in parallel manner, and they are in parallel because they have the same voltage VT across their terminals, and the current IT is getting divided at this node. And let us say that it is getting divided into the currents IR and IL. IR is the current through the resistor and IL is the current through the inductor. And let us say that the phasor of voltage VT is V phasor, and the phasor of current IT is I phasor, and the phasor of current IR is IR phasor, and the phasor of current IL is IL phasor. And when you apply the KCL at this node, you will have I phasor equal to IR phasor plus IL phasor. So we will have I phasor equal to IR phasor plus IL phasor. And we know that this resistor and this inductor together will offer some impedance to the current flow. And when we divide the voltage phasor by this impedance, we will have the current phasor. And therefore, we can write I phasor equal to V phasor divided by the impedance. And IR phasor, it will be equal to V phasor divided by R, V phasor divided by R, and IL phasor, it will be equal to V phasor divided by JXL, V phasor divided by JXL. Now when you take out V phasor common and then cancel it out with this V phasor, you will have 1 over Z equal to 1 over R plus 1 over JXL. Now when you multiply J in the numerator and J in the denominator, you will have negative of J multiplied to 1 over XL. So we will have 1 over Z equal to 1 over R minus J 1 over XL. And we know that inverse of impedance is called as admittance, and the inverse of resistance is called as conductance. We call it conductance, and the inverse of reactance we call susceptance. And here we have 1 over XL. This means we have inverse of inductive reactance. This means we will have inductive susceptance, and we represent admittance by uppercase Y, conductance by uppercase G, and susceptance by uppercase B. And here we have inductive susceptance, therefore we will write L. And finally, we can say that we have admittance equal to conductance minus J inductive susceptance. So in this way, we have all the relations to have our phasor diagram. And like earlier cases, I'm going to have my reference phasor drawn first. And this time, we are not going to have I phasor as the reference phasor because current is not same through resistor and inductor. This time, voltage is same across resistor and inductor, and therefore we will take V phasor as the reference phasor. Now moving on to IR phasor, we know it is the current through resistor, and therefore it will be in phase with V phasor. This is IR phasor. IL phasor is the current through inductor, and therefore it will lag V phasor by 90 degrees. And I phasor is the vector sum of IR phasor and IL phasor. Therefore, this vector here is I phasor. And we know that the angle between the net voltage phasor and the net current phasor is the power factor angle theta. So this is the phasor diagram of parallel RL circuit. And to have the current triangle, admittance triangle and power triangle, we will take this triangle and we will have the magnitudes. First, we will have the current triangle, the base will be current IR, the perpendicular will be current IL, and the hypotenuse will be current I. And current I from the triangle, we can say that is equal to under root IR square plus IL square. And this angle, which is the power factor angle, is equal to 10 inverse negative of IL, negative of IL divided by current IR. And the power factor, which is mathematically equal to cos theta, it is equal to IR divided by I, IR divided by I, and it will be lagging because we have inductor. Now moving on to the admittance triangle, this side is for conductance, this side is for inductive susceptance, and this side is for admittance. And admittance is equal to square of conductance plus square of susceptance. And the power factor angle, it is equal to 10 inverse negative of BL divided by G. And the power factor cos theta, it is equal to conductance divided by the admittance, and it will be lagging. Now moving on to the last triangle, which is power triangle. This side is the real power P, this side is the reactive power QL, and this side is the apparent power S. The apparent power is equal to under root square of real power plus square of reactive power. And the power factor angle theta, it is equal to 10 inverse negative of QL divided by P. And the power factor cos theta, it is equal to real power divided by the apparent power, and it will be lagging. So this is all for this lecture. I will end it here. See you in the next one.